another defensive war though from wings. Like one ward watching the other bit, the other one watching mid lane.
It's kind of expected, especially when you're on here.
30 seconds to battle.
Actually, oh, they're prepping for a ball. Cutting the tree. They're preparing to completely sack. Not sack, bottom of secret.
I like this. So it's not going to be a tiny.
It's the toss play. Echoes already. Gyrocopter. Come to first blood. Walked up there only into the ancient apparitions, chill time, as well as the shadows from Luffy.
Damage on the new chefs, by the way, guys, is absurd.
Yeah.
Like it's been buffed so many times that it's an independent new plus a disable. At the early phase of the game, it's incredibly strong. It is something that they have to worry about, but it's gonna be the keeper off. Mid, it's Doctor who be to kind of help us out a little bit, get things going.
Through so many trees.
And even stuff.
Denied!
I wanna see exactly how many times this. So he pulls the camp over and just tosses back.
Oh, they guess wrong. If he was there, they probably don't have kill on him. In fact. Arrow's gonna play up, not afraid of anything.
Hey, get the time right.
That is... Okay, this is something you actually have to practice.
He's pulled down, he can't even stack it that way. So that he failed to get the initial aggro of the second wave, top in the shackles, the gyrocopter, the Ember Spear, a perfect searing chain. She's in so much trouble, the attack from AA will be enough. Innocence has got no... defense nature, all he's got is the boots, so he has to move back away from Team Secret.
In a way, it's a defensive item build, just, you know, you play the Moose, the Rock Barrage and stuff like that. I doubt that he had any stat items, he survives there anyways. But it's just a really powerful trial that they have going. Kudos to Envy for leveling the series and change first.
Yeah, understood the comp. Okay, Faith did get the ball. So okay, he's finally dragged it over as Ice strikes the wave, but Misery's not gonna put
it in. If Misery actually makes this would be such a shame for him. He's
okay, it's willing death. In fact, he's not gonna survive this with the chain down. He got willing death back off cooldown, a good avalanche to find into space. And they're actually going for He'll get out. It's the middle lane which is trouble. Shackled from Winter under the back of the Bristleback, and now they're throwing a couple far from down. He'll get picked off. Courier was even delivering in the bottle. Kalia did know the entire way, or else he would have lost the courier with the bottle as well.
Yeah, and it was hard for this the Bristleback to survive. He only has one the Bristleback. On top of that, the Rangers is a difficult matchup. And most importantly, Team Secret, they have a rough idea of where Ward are. But that still probably should have been called by Wings. The two people up there, especially when you're running an aggressive rally, should kind of just signal to hey, they might be getting aggressive and
miss back in. Yes, he chains downhill and then cuts his way to free.
Oh no, himself. He's doing pretty well. Alright.
I was actually wondering why Free didn't look for a little bit more region, something like, I don't know if the Fairy Fire is really the place to go from, but some of the players using that yesterday to escape from those rotation ganks. You saw both instant 150.
Yeah, it's a really interesting item. I know I was talking to Pri about it, he thinks it'd be a little bit too expensive for what it gives you, but the fact that you can just like instantly restore HP, it really messes with people's Dota map. And another thing that's so important is Dota things are so precise that you almost never want just enough, right? Rotate heroes or anything like that.
Yep.
But when it comes to items like Fairy Fire or the Wand, it completely screws up your makes it so that no longer what you expect. Pretty good pickup on different heroes.
Misery is really kind of getting up to the Tiny, and Tiny might try and push him. Faith with actually just throw Misery back. When it's only 5 charges from because there's only one that. Like, this as well, Faith can't do anything about it. Surprising too, wouldn't go to something else like a man. Someone like a Tiss.
Yeah, this is a little of the map. Especially when you can use the hook a brew, because it's a slow spell. But I guess just opting to go for something a little bit more deep and heavy. I don't even know if control there. And
so do I. You could actually work with it as well. It's all pretty good with.
Misery is starting to kind of get low. That's how to start with this. I think he might not. I hear
yeah. With the rotation coming, the Illumina is going to connect. A tiny with the end up top gets the kill.
Radiant structure.
So you can slow and relax up on the top lane, but Shadow's been good getting inside the trap and away from the vision.
I think potentially without the next player there, they've been killed for them. He was so low. But the knight there means that he can rotate into this lane. I think they want putting a little bit of pressure on. Unfortunately for them, only a level 1 and the level void doll doesn't do too much for you. The shift to there. I'm gonna take a hit for this as well. And you need this gang to work with wings. I'm gonna go behind him and fight.
Yeah. Yeah, she has the voice.
But no!
Faithfuls. Keeps the wind going. Runs up the river. No, he can harass it a little bit into Weeha, but don't get more.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Unfortunate event after unfortunate event. That's with maybe something stalker silencing? Mm-hmm. Maybe that's. I lack damage, I'm not sure.
A little bit anyway, like, Weeha have seen six one charges when they come in. Last thing, free fire.
Yeah, pretty much good if they get that kill.
Yep.
If you're nice stalker, or has level 2. That's a potential, but he's gone for one kill build. It really does hurt you. But 4 seconds at levels for Void. But now it's 2.5 and then skip.
Still crank your bottom. Shot right up. It's the mission which will be the most successful game. Smoke apart. They're around, but just the right time. Not be able to get those shackles. Difficult fight during time. Is Reaper? He's almost up and running.
That's when his farm starts to end. It should be. He's even pop. They just went into jungle here. It is only.
With that illuminated and his pump so heavily. Cold in the night. Stalking. With the help of us. He's gonna bring down Pylite.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
The ability and mixing up. I'm getting lost on my blitz.
I'm proud. Right. That was so well up. The wings.
They.
Into the tree line. They.
I was actually interested in two things we're going to plant. Just such a defensive arm with their ward. Like, a lot of the time we was in place a little bit closer to the ramp, deeper inside the ramp, and manipulate it for the hell. It gives you so much movement.
If you play as aggressive as possible with the ward, in the early game, you can get a high ground. Humans click, but. Past that, you won't. I the game still has, especially when you run a lineup, like an offlane titan. He not scale too well. Try to get a decent early start. Notes as a and a top. I don't know, he's just.
You try to bait him as far away as people understand that they're still behind. They're still actually being different while battling out. Back, there was no way to do the damage.
No, I think even the Stalker boys don't have a finishing.
I'm was able to watch what they're doing, but the rating absorbs it. And also understands where face movement is, so they can't take him by surprise. And really surprisingly, is the fact we can't get so much in the middle lane of the brute.
Dire's structures are fortified.
So we had a focused fire down that mid.
Is under attack.
He's gonna even power shot. He knows for a fact that the port wants to verify this.
Okay. Manually going on the Ember Spirit, he's waited longer, and now, in fact, he starts attacking in ice. He's already been denied the putback, but Heavy, he killed. The question is, can he get out of this one? You can fit for a Keeper of a Life. He's got Spirit available, as well as if he needs life, and there it is. Spirit of Faith, just waiting for him. 500 level 6 tiny now because of the kill. Another rock man.
I mean, I understand the point of when he goes in on the Keeper of the Light, he doesn't think they'll have enough, especially in the time, but... And that, like, really did... He's like that last few, you know, to... Like, I might die, but I've got... Just even Poppy, get Poppy, but... He's better.
It's just a recon test. He was with Lex, he needed to actually get the other... That's what he's doing on the bottom, but he's still thinking, like, if you look at the network wall, the top is to the secret core. Like, we can't be very full that ahead of the crystal back. They've only brought down the tower. I believe I should die.
Yes, it was. Which was unfortunate because we have committed so much, he couldn't even have that because he just had to come on the tower for that particular and it up. Like, get aggressive. I commit this
shit at least. We are purpose. I don't just life on him, but then again, he's just. So he does something to work with.
And we just got careful as this flame bird starts to take down. Up there too. And a 25 gold. They close that blink dagger. What they're gonna need to start their fights. They put so much tiny. If he doesn't get a blink dagger at a reasonable time, what do they really do to kill him? Unless somebody from Secret overcommits it.
They get out and out. Keep a really, like, high buff. They don't quiet. Come back. Everyone's getting surrounded. They still don't have dash unless they can keep him controlled. There it is. But finally, Weehaw, he keeps up. He's got his one shot as well. He'll get out and come to the Eternal Levy. Chase that character. The Lost of Faith already finds a kill. The other flying in, but the only one really being affected by this. He still can't get a kill, Keeper of the Light. The Blind Light forced him back out, and now you got Russell back. No Spirit, there's Barrett. Deep Chaz will trigger, and he'll get himself back in the Meridian Jungle. But he's got nothing more to give.
That was such a loser situation to the Bristleback. He's like, you lose? He doesn't have map. I'll give to him if I continue chase. That's like high level. It might get a big rebuttal here.
Does he have
one second?
Rotation. Misery's that word now.
Really amazing for him. That puts him up to 11. Two level above. One range. It's the gyro. It is just prepping a trap. Pray that it's actually meant to do the thing. If it's coming out and one bar trap, I don't know. He arrives, it just can't run from this one. Still, it actually spins back and then eats the end. The Toss of Faith trying to keep Envy from, but it's just not possible. There's two jump available. Chase underneath the town. Focus fire from Weehaw. Rip down the Tiny. Trying to win. Bristleback for the Quill. Back trying to kick in. Force active over the Ranger. That's equal disengage. Wings gain more support, but they just can't keep the chase up.
Yeah, without the Tiny or their Night Stalker available, there's almost a chance that they get any sort of rebuttal. Well, for all that. Kind of they were able to find the first goff on the next. As soon as Tiny goes down, they know almost no rebuttal. As long as he keeps his spirit up, they've got such multiple heroes with their core. Temper Saw's got Temper Chain, the Ember Spirit has Fire Spirit, Windrun. It's incredibly mobile to keep up with something like that. Especially when you're pullback. Like, you're trying so hard. Full one goof is okay, like 20% boost, but you really like stun in this situation like that.
Smoking on a for an opening. Maybe on Puppy is the way to go. Yep, it is. Oh. Avalanche toss. It's the first big hit of Black Dagger of Fate. Kenny's found this. We're rotating over now. Link is still on cooldown.
Oh, he's
and then Pokeball. And being back over bait. Oh, he'll get the top. First up, we have doing the final bits of damage. In fact, it's gonna be the Emperor Spirit. Envy kill secure that. We had it most of the work.
Radiant's middle tower really good pick is off. Under attack.
He's going to pick up the boss on. He's in the losing other core. Wings can't really afford something like this. Like, their lineup do have a decent team fight. Like, not as much control as by SCG. His top lane are not very tanky. He's got control. As he can fall down, both of us are going to rotate in. Misery. The Seth comes off too. They might have enough damage for this, but he does have some suicide.
Get it off. It's actually something which we saw yesterday actually. Radiant's with MVP when they were playing.
We're
certain if it's a bug, or if it was actually the frame. That was the switch we got from MVP with, like, just
Radiant structures
timing was off.
It's okay though. Well, he's gonna reach pretty quickly. That Bloodstone makes his way up top almost immediately. Not as important for a hero like Timbersaw to stick up on blood charges. They or anything like that. Still.
Don't want to go back.
Yeah, exactly. He's stable. So
Wings are really prepared for this top lane fight. Using a just half effect mana leak it now actually size. He went for like 0-2 and now everything else he's putting in. Realizing just how powerful it is.
Is that against the Windrun and the Timber Chain, actually the Ember Spirit too, actually, it's going to be incredibly powerful, and most importantly, they just need something to continue the Disobedient.
Here it jumps in with the Ash Toss, we came in line, that's one, it's going to hit him, they're far enough back with the rest of Wings, they don't get affected, but the first up, there's your tip, some, suicide.
Really, really.
They have to tackle over tiny Ember Spirit thing in, VTs. Wings is back out. They want to retreat as they possibly can. Meg back off cooldown. Kills in control. Tiny running line. Puppy back in. Connect fate still locked in. Blue. Very nicely. Damage on the Wings a little too high. Jacob is about to go down. Really rock rush in the pump. He's run out of mana. We need to get done. They have the void. There's still a daytime fight. Ice Blast probably almost ensure the kill over. We are going to get one thing off, but he's got nothing in the tank. Both health and map. So let's get the double kill on that side. Misery. One. Now, what was this misery? We get some man came out of it as well. Missed the tip of Jill. Let's have Frostbite a little bit more time to be into him. Three stacks up. Love the young goo. Has to miss another chance. There's no teeth for Misery to jump. He'll go down to both the Night Stalker and the Bristleback.
That's going to be 6 for Secret. They lose a lot of heroes for that instrument. Envy. They're a little big. He decides to go in. Since so deep and try to get the turn. The strength is coupled with the fact that the person from Wings played Radiant's so well. The key for the like a leak on pretty much every single target. And kind of get that last draw off when he gets it off onto the Timber. Pretty good fit for all of them is that 6 heroes. Pull it with the blood suicide leading into the fight. Now that is a very melee 3 blood charges for Misery. Like, we were complaining about, like, if at 8 he'd be just being reset. It's okay. 1-1, right? You'll get back that, but I take a full team wipe. Panic is the normal for him. Maybe he doesn't have a devoted so much to getting into early engagements.
Then with this, the rest went. It's just not as far as probably expected. Turtle lead to be. Surprise, Brusselback. Maybe one of those surprises is that he can't be. After watching most of the battles coming out yesterday, the Vanguard and Krasingard were highly prioritized from the Brusselbacks, as well as even just being a casual cloak, so you just tanked everything. Get the early mid booster if you wanted to, well.
It's like there's more of a focus though.
Yeah.
The mech completed on the line. And this could be the Roshan for Team Secret.
It's a Wing Scout. They're grouping up for a smoke and they're coming down. They're going through this. And without the gyrocopter, this might be a bit more difficult. But this is going to break. Does he go for it? There's this blast running in the. Matching him to the tree line. It forces the Secret ripping down Roshan. Does terrible damage at the moment. And the gyrocopter has arrived with cooldown. We are locked inside the pit. Get him trying to escape. At this point, it's one for two trade off. Nice will all die heavy. Into Shabas, the bridge back on the front line. Starting to stack up. Shaman, who doesn't really have much mana, can't shut up. They put in the kill. Ember's standing around the mana. He doesn't want to stop it. Ember's even getting dumped by the rocket. There's mana now into the helicopter. Thanks to the Keeper of the Light. In the
oh, another mana leak.
The mana leak. Man, the first gun. Kill comes away and shatter. The big thanks to Ice support. Keep fighting. Hero's real.
The Bristleback just goes in under everything with early BKB pickup. Looked like early good game by Seeker when they were able to burst down the time. Radiant's middle disastrous for them attack. As 5 attack for these was a strong.
Still managed to, keep up the Aegis so terrain. Lose that mob. Just coming in with a clown. Is Minfi gonna get hit hard by that? They weren't really safe for this. They start mana like over the weaver. They manic pushed back. Blood all of his mana. He keeps the run going. And he's actually out. Behind the hit. And they Radiant's top tower is under attack. Turtle Envy's back on living. But innocent, he starts to keep on this wall. He's in the middle of 4 tiers of wings. Town is going to go down the Illuminate again. And the first back. Again, that AKB is enough that he's able to kill the kill. We things just pulling a beautiful man ball into secret.
I mean, you're seeing the power of the mana. I can't ability because it's so much. You see Viha right there in the situation. He doesn't run up, but he doesn't want to run away. He's kind of like, this is such a lose-lose situation. If I run, I'll just get stunned up. If I don't, then I die anyways. Ice, he's got so much around. Almost the agonist scepter cleated. Radiant's top tower has fallen. When things start to get rough, it's a lot of vision during both the game.
He's in the hell out of there. Back still. Playing just by the space of half a second. If they be able to get there a little sooner. We'll be ability 717. Winged with the golden edge now, stretching over 2,500. Not really that big for 21 minutes. The game just shows you the wings is still standing toe to toe with Team Secret.
Yeah, and now they've usurped in worth it. The gyrocopter, who was heavily pushed earlier in the game, is caught completely at the end of the two. This makes him incredibly tough kill. Them a lot of team fight potential, too. Although the Agonist Doctor on the Witcher complete, it just kind of feels like. They're being stoned out part by both supports. Attack.
So it feels like Weedon's never able to attack. Like, every time he comes to a Giver with blind sight, that yeah. Is almost done. Overall, the Keeper. Which Dyer's is a little ironic that primarily Dyer's because he's running with the Night Stuff.
Yeah, I think the TP is what he's done. They're gonna go for the spot attack. Radiant's bottom tower. Dyer's top tower. Dyer's top tower. Shout out 1-1. That's perfect. Fine.
The battle area, but we're getting a little bit of time, so it's a 3-3 for a 10-1B.
2 off your time now, considering how this game's gone. And this is when starts to turn the Amber Spirit.
Coming out of Innocence is wrapping around. They want to have a crack at Misery. He blinked himself back. Misery is. Keep free away at the tower.
I'd have damage for this. They wouldn't need another hero. One isn't really interested in rotating in.
What do you think about to build over from Puppy? Actually avoiding going for something like a Burning Dagger, so he's going the positional initiation. Instead he goes for Assault with the AK.
You need the armor. It helps against rooms like Black, Tiny Gyrocopter, couple rewards, Radiant's a little bit more damage out there. Under attack. For, I guess, the other item that you would kind of consider the Agonim, but doesn't do as much. Like, Solar Crest also allows you to go for your early Roshan a little quicker. And it appears obviously with the Windraker.
The Envy back up to the top lane. Most of the rest of his team is normally Envy's the one that's away from what the rest of his team is taking as push from. Radiant's middle
tower is under kind attack. Of leaving part though, like every time he's in there was first, but he's being punished much more heavily than he normally is. game like this.
Tends to be Timber still got a lot of momentum behind him. Big he does play kind of like the sponge ball as inner MC.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Misery doesn't have any real momentum on him. You know, he's got this blinker. The net was fairly high up in his team and not far behind wings. He doesn't seem to have that presence in the fight.
Tower's gonna get traded out those results. Teams just by virtue of the previous are kind of just avoiding, trying to outmaneuver a little bit, the actual control. Yeah, good job with it.
Give me spectacle to keep mapping. Faith waiting. She gave it the slot fit on the end. We'll see what Emph got. We're all the way up. It's a way to build damage. Keep light at attack, Scepter done. So it's a lot more aggressive out in the enemy jungle or wherever, and just be back in Team Secret Prime 4. Then again, is that even Secret's plan? Like, the plan was it plan to look for team fights against Wings?
I think that you're gonna try to over the farm out jungle and then for sort of smoke thing, but crazy how Wings line up will be just the amount of vision that their cores give them. Got one core in the Keeper of Light that gives you unobstructed day vision, and then once the Night Stalker gets. Unobstructed, so you pick up a gem and see everything.
It's kind of funny, that's why I don't fully think both of them together, because you can walk like at the time.
But you know,
an avalanche server on the ice is on the way, and Drew will be able to get himself up. But a quick got themselves a stun, just for him. He only escaped.
That's kind of what would he kill from? That is what they're making. Of course, they still have to worry about this. The Tursal is ahead of the Windranger in there. They're gonna steal some drops over here, and now it's Wings gonna soak up.
Moving up to the Dire Jungle. And it's like Weeha, the Blink Avalanche, but Weeha too quick.
Out there. It's just awkward going up that hill. I think Wings had some idea that he was there, but why not? You don't have a weapon. You're just kind of looking and blind. Weeha sees that coming 100%. It's just more reaction time.
If he wasn't standing like in this region, like if he was a little bit further up, then it would have been a better chance for him. And that's a lot of stacks on the Aegis too. Shadow's getting such a huge eject money. Wait, is he getting pulled out as he's starting up the Ancients? Yeah, he's dragging him over. He found me. He needs the extra damage of Gyrocop to ensure the kill. With a blind, Gyrocop gets up, the rocket can hit connect, and he just gives himself a shaman. And what is happening to? Is he just going directly for the Yag Sniper and turn himself into a core? Or do you still try to keep going for this pick style?
I think going for something team oriented, I think the Aghanim is still incredibly strong just because it's buffed pretty hard.
Sorry, he's getting so much of the agents. He can't tank it enough though. You can't fix the job.
Did you just laugh in real life?
I actually did.
Can the viewer even hear that?
Sorry.
Alright, Toby.
It was a sound.
He actually just stopped everything you were doing. His hands went farting agents.
It's the steal, man! Sustains. Shit, a good bomb.
You would have really loved 2013.
Actually, that was terrible. That, you mean the tide torch?
Smoke into the enemy ancients to steal it.
I enjoyed the Chinese scene, which would have been at 9 years ago, where it was all about fighting over the ancients. Always battle for the vision on the dire side over their ancients, and they would just go like time and time again, just run people over. They'll be stacking the ancients while they're team fighting. It was superb.
They've got a Night Stalker.
Yeah, they're gonna run it. That's just too easy on a shaman. And he's got himself like this solo boost. That's a another tanky shit. Still nothing. This wing's initiation.
This is what he does best. Goth support heroes and wasn't really slowed down in the early, so he's able to keep up and continue to do this.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Wings look like they're about to win this game. The team just so strong.
They still push from the gonna go high ground, or how gonna be on expert. Got a lot of different capabilities, and pressing into the base might be a little bit more difficult for them. The strength for them is the open plains, is the ability to fight everywhere. That guy is gonna gone on. He does have a cloak up, though, I believe. Should be okay.
Sentry went down. The shack flies, we're land, and not to allow fate to chimp. We are standing line. Support coming in. Always for recall to keep the light in the field. Call out. He gets a wonderful war trap over on Faith. Takes as well to break him free, but they can't do it in time. But you're gonna lose E. Over in the tree. Shadow up. And now also the ward phone goes on wings. You just sacrificed a tree, which he's pretty happy to do. 400 gold away from his Aghanim. That answers your question how you can go high ground. You've got a tiny that can beat through the buildings. Get a pick off the vision they got.
With the rush tracks. And up, they do this beautiful bristleback. Continue to go up. Just through, and they're gonna push on misery, but this is more just.
They've got unobstructed vision here. Can't be, yes, they can. Well, two bloodstones.
Look at that damage.
Come on, one bloodstone die.
That bristle hits so hard. With knife up on my finger. Absolutely cuts through this.
This is the beauty of it. This is the beauty. And this is the reason the Bristleback used to get fixed when, the old lane where you ran. Jakiro is safe in the Bristleback off lane. For a little bit, takes all this physical damage because of his
pop. Roshan has fallen to the dire.
Engineer. He uses the shadow. He has his BKB now. 1800 gold. Full 10 second BKB charge on him. The Bristleback. He had his BKB so early. First Roshan engagement, still 8 seconds on him. I was a little bit concerned I'm gonna go for the high ground and how you continue to the chase when you've got like post 7-8 second BKBs, which they do. You got the Aegis off of them as well. The Tiny's almost got the Aghanim Scepter, which he does complete now.
Actually, at the 5 inventory, everything looks open in line. 2 SMI fight on the trigger as well, the girls are back in the tracks, which just fall off. Wonderful display and secret comes to the question again, what do they do to stop this pressure from things? Because they seem to keep getting picked up across the map, but how do you stop that from also happening? You can't vision up against a Night Stalker and a Coddle, both have Aghanim Scepter.
Takes to be his one really good engagement for Team Secret. Still have Ember as a core, he's incredibly strong, but he might just damage against someone. But there's always an item that MV can so much more can punch in this game than I've seen in previous. Man, as soon as gets casted on, both just like I'll play them. No chance.
Several dangers for MV. With a chase, for it doesn't have. But even when
Misery's gonna get top back.
The shackle open. That's a bit of Adam. They just call him. They throw it at the surf force. This is so trap. It's a cook it away. He was inside Chakra. And Puffy, while Shadow's beating in Thor, we are is completely out of mana. Shadow, keep this pressure. We are pulling himself into the trees, waiting for Vision of Wings.
Now with the wards down too, like, this is going to kind of signal Wings. And they do lose their for the light, which has played such a significant part in their strategy spar. But I think there's sitting going in is. Yep. Misery's gonna get tossed back.
That was Fate Mark with just hitting Tibisol for a moment, and then he just so with the side. He's still just hovering on one.
Bottom is under attack.
Hey, I'm charged to rule the lands. Toby playing unafraid. Not even sending a message. But he's gonna go for the push. This is absolutely what he needs to do. Now his team is in no position, especially against Aegis Strokecopter, who. He's got a Link Sphere. I don't know if it's the item, but it's that.
Does he break out? What does it really stop? Stop initiation from the Shaman. He's initiated in, well, 34 minutes and.
I think it's a shot. one of the first heroes with that Aegis. It's not even just that, you can place it on other heroes as well. Go for Honor Shackle, I'm sure we'll see.
Bristleback got a bash build, so a Bristleblade is on the way for him. Let's see if he finished something. You get armor items on the Bristleblade. No ace, no Shiva's got. You want overall, in effect.
You get built on the pretty. Just another confactor that. Not black, but. Seems as though Mana Leak plus back is enough. PK is completed on Leon. This was the item that we were waiting for. Like, this is something that he needed. He got mad for the fight.
He looks for the ship, but he can't get it. Tripping from Brookback with Splink. It's really difficult for Weehash. He latched that shackle within changes. Because of the minimum damage that Great Wave bump. That's just big mistake. They keep getting hit up. These are loops. It just bumps the wings. So much health. The ice bumps. Fly into the dark, in a little bit of trouble. Got the Aegis model, so even if Shadow does appear, he's still going to survive.
Now he should probably find a Glimmer too, if they needed. Dire's bottom tower is getting pretty low. I'm actually in the middle of the bot yet healed. Be fake that. He's not the creative. Now they have to worry about this top lane. This bot, actually, yeah.
Envy doing Envy things. He's back.
It could be called them.
Yep. And that's the power of strength, isn't it? You can just keep push as well. Keep that pressure on with some quill spreads and let Hyde do his work on the bottom lane. Gyro definitely wants up to keep all the lanes pushed in. And Team Seek have to keep multiple people in that middle.
The Beekeeper light pick is perfect so far for them. Like, they need to just kind of rotate in and out. If they're gonna head back to this mid lane, they do still want to make. To the fact that they're ahead, the Aegis is down now, but Jono's just gonna replace that with the Demon Edge. Be their high ground attempt as they know they're not going to push pressure.
That's my jumps, they can Firelight die, ability off. Maybe there's a generation of Wings. Wings can just go to town. They hit for the ever, and Eternal Envy's gonna transflow that up with the Fisterian Chain onto the Bristleback. Not a lot of life on him, the board is a mech, but when he jumps for another avalanche toss, he's gonna go down with victory out of the target right. Able to find that target. Shadow, this cooldown of bubbly, there's no reason why it's down, so Shadow's not really fucking any damage on side for take by this KB. He has over the blink, a boy that again, illumined from ice. Wings will start to back out. Their goal was one of those, they took the mid ranks on AA trade off. Pressure. Seems to be a good trade. Now Bristleback. Well, actually, we can't take the region route.
For a second, they won the attempt there, but.
It looked like they're pushing just to, like, shred the pot.
Deal.
They couldn't control. It was getting close. It was more slash. That makes things to have a base site.
It's one of my concerns right now, TC. Shaman can't really get into the mix of things. Like, you can't afford to just go shackling and hexing and be like, I got all things. You immediately get down by either the tiny or the black. And so, you can get the wards that already does, but this does mean that they're gonna lack level in the control department. Envy can't afford to be in the middle of the fights either. Come down with NBK, the natural tankiness of Timbersaw. Does have a full plate mail and go scepter completed. This is an incredibly defensive build.
Had no other choice. I guess it's that or walking around no zone for life. Looks like Wings is coming back in again. Middle is gonna push itself in, but doing anything is gonna creep skip out. Doesn't wanna come underneath the tier 2 tech. That corral, you don't want to lose this. It's got this stick staff on it. Has been killed.
Right.
That was actually the full sheet. Just inside. Okay. Envy. He's got another spirit to jump out. He just killed all of it.
Fortunately for Wing, though, no way to really punish this. Honestly, they're just waiting for the next round. bit too hard to breach high ground with what they have right now, Toby. And so you just waited out a little bit, play patient. So much map control. Everybody from Secret is afraid to leave the base. Afraid to get mana leaked.
Not surprised. Could just put this, this. Just keep following me across the map. You got 12,000 net worth advantage and it just continues to rise. And Secret can't really do anything to stop you. One surprising thing from Wings though, the fact they don't have any observables on the map. Yeah, I don't know if I just see it, like, taking care of like, getting rid of them all the time.
No, it's fine. It's when you're far ahead and you've got Jeff or anything, and anything like that, plus the Night Stalker Agnims, you've got moving wards.
Team Secret have had enough of waiting.
I kind of would like to see, like, hills.
Yeah. Just a hillside. So they can
come on, guys.
Ask the world, man. Oh, nice. Good triggers the ulti. These pylites, smoke fake. Wallace Puppy Faith with the blink over. Looking for the opening and there it is. Pylite dies once again. The BKB will protect the hit by the damage of the ice blast. Even if he does get chilled up, we are on this run. Blinks himself down the way. But he won't be so lucky. The blink followed by Faith as well. And it's time to align.
Oh, that jackal!
The jackal hits perfect. The pylite instrumental set up for the call down here from Shadow. Kind of damage, it'll be a doom for doom trade off. Yes, they're there, but they're not doing enough damage. And the rest of Team Secret are so certain they won't be fighting. Wings need to, they can just buy back and recall their heroes. They don't need to. Place.
I don't think you can afford it. The Ember Spear does the amount of damage, so even everything, and that shot from Weeha, that's all they needed. Connect and it finally does on 2-4 heroes right there, and they still did quite a lot of damage. This Tiny isn't here with Will Hope. He's got 12 armor. That's all crystal. I'm at least self.
Wondering if it's worthwhile Wings now moving into a. Like. Something like a side over on a Tiny. Do you expect to the damage that a Tiny can be? Wait for him to come out and then leave you and go high. Are you getting. Now, but even one good slap is clearing. Wings saw what that was capable of doing. They either made a team fight or just not finding a pickup. And it looks like Tom's just going for the anyway. So the armor advantage will be is just dying so blinding. Actually puts it back. Hard, I can't even deward at the moment. Faithful, we are doing the advantage will connect. They really want to pick. They're getting again. It's just too low. They throw forward with the crystal into the edge of apparition for 4 seconds without the AA. But what is Wings really going to get? Their creep wave is not too far. The side lanes are also on the wrong side of the room.
You probably put too much pressure on this after the fact, but your Wings got the Aegis. No creep in the bottom lane, but I not really even care. With that you have right now, with Bristleback having the Aegis, Link, Abyssal Blade, somebody blow them up. It's gonna be Shadow that's gonna be left behind and eventually be called in.
Yep. Shackle, lads again from Weeha, Misery moves forward. They're tossing the Bristleback to reposition. Bristleback takes so much damage from Weeha still, and they just got a chains. The Bristleback, Mega Chow comes up behind Misery. Abyssal Blade, he's gonna look handy. Still gonna do some work and fake. Shackle to a drink. It was Jackal by Puppy as well. The whole different types of bondage on the face still breaks free. 126 plus. They throw Weeha up, but Weeha, he'll bring money down. Back to the fight. So Puppy with the shackles and the shot. The damage is never too high for Bristleback. The Night Stalker is actually in a blink way and almost no life whatsoever. And Team Secret, they have EE as well as Misery alive. They still can finish the job of Night Stalker. Fighting it out under the Wings. And he goes to the TP, but that's not going to work. Night Stalker's back. Oh, it's Ice. They're two buybacks, and then out there, like, hitting them again.
So, what an innocence there. The fact that he was able to just kind of play around with 200 HP, not really caring. But he's going to lay down for suppressing fire so that they can deal some damage on this tower. But it's going to be the Shackle attempts that does go on the Bristles. Walks away. Since once again, he's going to be the lead.
He just keeps running in.
400 HP, doesn't even really care, gets a silence off, sure that Envy has to up. They're not gonna get the tower, and that was one of the main objectives. They do force out a lot of buybacks. Same time, Key Light uses buyback.
Yeah,
I'm reading that right. And Gyrocopter has 6.2k. Is a satanic now, fully completed. This is gonna help their Aryon push out quite a lot, but.
There's one upside for Secret. The Monkey King Fire is now being purchased by Eternal Land. He's had enough of Blind and Light. Enough of his hits.
Are you 100% certain that that's gonna be an MKB?
He bought the image of Courier and then brought Courier back. That's the reason why I lean towards not towards the Rapier. I'm also very concerned if he does the Rapier. I touched on probably 20 minutes ago, the fact that you don't have the Spirit Vision anymore for the Emperor, it's really, really dangerous to go for something like the Rapier if you don't know what you're going into. So the split push of Envy, you almost have to leave Rapier at base until Wings push and then grab it.
Dangerous is middle main, man. He's okay with that.
I remember the word from Puppy, it's like, Envy wants to go on Rapier, I trust him.
He should. Made it work time and time again. Like, this was the item that they used to bring themselves back.
Well, they found Innocent Sweetheart. Needs the control, however. The Link Diva's gone from Misery. He was expecting the rest of Wings to be on the other side of that tree line, but it weren't.
They gotta get out and reset the fight. They're under Ward Vision right now. I don't want to get collapsed on it. That's what's happening right now.
He's just walking himself in, gets a double avalanche. Innocent Zink gets the
shackle. Oh, that's shackle!
They'll drop the gem, the planet web, and the blinding light's gonna get a lot of space here for Wings. Even though she isn't absolutely perfect.
Ward drop though, and see this. Back out.
They lost it.
That was awkward. When you toss one hero, you're trying to toss somebody back, but then the tiny blinks forward and gets shackled to the Night Stalker. These are not tanky heroes. They have to play the position game and cannot get shackled there. And he's out of mana and.
Spirit available though.
He should be fine.
He needs to keep the web pushed out anyway, but this isn't really a choice of his. He didn't stick around, like, two swings. There's the Monkey King, but with two swings, he would have taken out his creep bottom. He didn't want to overstay his welcome. Fresh gem over on Wings. But, with worth advantage, they've got the cash to do it. But now they go again. Look, this one from Gyro, and point blank up. That is one great death, Shaman.
He does have buyback somehow. I don't know if Puppy continues to afford things. But he's scraping buyback full. Doesn't have the ward for 46 seconds. The significant part for his teammate. And Shadow's getting shackled up. He has Satanic available. Not gonna do too much when he gets by the A plus.
Just avoid it. The avalanche toss, they got the mark over on Misery. Tries to run himself out of the call down. Emphasis Spirit just went in with the Abyss Blade.
They
and
Envy
now this movie, that no Puppy he died. And bottom rack just been obliterated by Wings. It's like Secret don't have anything else really in the arsenal to battle against Wings. They've lost too much.
Yeah, we have the KP down to 6 seconds on 2. It's ground. They should be able to get Mega Creeps off. It's gonna make one last ditch ever. You're gonna need the craziest fight possible.
Oh, not Shackle. No, that's GG. That is GG. The Unblast hit on as many people as they want at the end. They're going to take game number one. The first game of this group up against Team Secret. Obviously, has a very certain road for a lot of the top teams, and the Team Secret is gonna be no exception.
That was such a well played by Wings. Their strategy worked out really well. Might have, like, relevant even the liking of my perceived, the amount of times that they were